Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. As you can see here, I've got myself a PlayStation Vita.
Well, here's a little animation from Sony on what the Vita hardware was all about. It's got an OLED screen on it, mine has anyway. There's an LCD version as well. And it had Wi-Fi or 3G GPS. My version only has Wi-Fi on it. And of course it had two cameras, one at the front and one at the rear. And obviously it was known for having touchscreen at the front and touchpad at the back.
It's the Call of Duty Black Ops version 1003 model. And I also got with it, it came with 512 GB micro SD card, and it also had the Vita to SD card adapter here as well. Being a 1000 model, it's also got the custom 4 GB memory card as well, which is needed on this model. To jailbreak it, I'm going to be following the guide on the website VitaDeploy.hacks.guide, and you can follow along as well. Right guys, let's begin the procedure. First, a few precautionary steps we have to take. Make sure your battery is full. You don't want the battery to go dead when you're doing this procedure, otherwise you might risk breaking your device. Also, go into the settings here, and then go right to the bottom. Go to where it says power save settings, and make sure it's set at 30 minutes. You don't want it going to power saving mode either when you're doing this procedure. What else? Next, you want to go into the web browser here, and you want to go into settings and make sure you delete your cookies, and also clear your search history as well. This will allow the exploit to work better. Sometimes with the clear back prayer, once you clear those settings, it will be easier to hack. Okay, we can begin the next step now. Right, for the PlayStation Vita 1000 series, because they don't have any memory inside them, you're going to need the memory card, which I showed earlier, the proprietary one, and not a micro SD card. For the 2000 models, you don't need it. There is a way to get it working on the 1000 series without the memory card. That's by basically removing the NIR app here and using its space. But since I've got a memory card, I won't be doing that on this model here. The memory cards are pretty cheap. You can get them from eBay or computer exchange for a couple of pounds. So get them, it makes life much easier. Right, so what you want to do is check what your system firmware is. This one came with 3.65 here, and what we're going to do is update it to 3.74. It's not needed if you're on 3.65, but I'll do it for the sake of this video. So connect to your Wi-Fi. I'll do that and fast forward this bit. Right, I've entered my Wi-Fi password in, and I'm connected to the internet now. the next step is to update to 3.74. Update using Wi-Fi. So, let's update the system. Right, the process is done. It was fairly quick. Took about a minute. Let's confirm it. Here you go, 3.74. Okay, on to the next step. Right, now we've done that. The firmware has been updated. We have to go to the browser and go to the particular website. So find the Vita's browser, which is here, and start it. Okay, go to this website, http://... and then go to jailbreak.psp2.dev. Now on this website, you just click on the Unlock My Vita. So let's click on that. And then click on Unlock. Right. The handler settings will appear now. So what you want to do is install Henkaku and VitaDeploy. So let's do that. By the way, if you don't have a memory card, you can use this option here, number 3, where it will place the near application, which I showed earlier. And basically it will make a memory card for you, and then you just format it all again, but I recommend just getting a memory card. Okay, install Henkaku. And install VitaDeploy. And then exit. Right, we're back again onto the main apps page here, and we've got the VitaDeploy installed here, but we don't want to do that yet. We want to go to settings. Now we've got a new option here, Henkaku settings. And what you want is to tick unsafe homebrew. Spoofed version. change it to 3.74. Okay, now we need to find the VitaDeploy app which we installed earlier on. So, what we want to do is run VitaDeploy, click start, don't click install, just click start. We need the hack to be permanent. At the moment we're not permanent. Anytime we reboot or anything like that, the hack will go back to, the Vita will go back to a stock Vita. So, find this option here, install a different OS, quick 3.65 install. And let it download from the internet. Do not let the Vita go into sleep mode. Okay, now we have the Modoru application, which means to go back basically in Japanese. So it's going to downgrade us from 3.74 to 3.65. Is an important step, so make sure you're fully charged and everything's ready to go. And just press X to confirm it. Press X to accept the terms and start the installation. Okay, it's done. As you can see, we've got the battery meter now, percentage meter, which we didn't have before. Right, once it's gone back to 3.65, go into settings. As you can see, 3.65 Enso. Go into Henkaku if you haven't already, spoof the version back to 3.74. Oh sure, make sure the auto start setting is make sure the auto download auto update file for system software is off, otherwise it will update back to 3.74 and have to do the whole procedure again. Now we are basically jailbroken and it's time to install some applications. Okay, let's run VitaDeploy. Go to App Downloader, which is here, and you want to install Vita Shell, which is a file manager, Homebrew Store, VitaDB, ITTLS, which is basically for encryption support. And I'm going to install that for SD YAMPT installer. I'm going to install Intralinen, and I'm going to install PKG. And then click download selected apps. Here we are, the apps are installed. Right guys, here we go, we've got all the applications installed. We've got the Vita Shell to manipulate the file system, VitaDB, the Homebrew Store, ITLS Enso to update the protocol standards to allow web browsing, YAMPT, which allows you to use the SDVITA card, and we've got Adrenaline, which is a PSP emulator. And finally we've got PKG, which is basically allows you to download PSP games, PlayStation 1 games, Vita games and stuff like that. Right, that about is all for this video, and if you liked it, give it a thumbs up, and if you've got any questions, leave a comment below, and hit subscribe, it really helps me out. Cheers.